leadership that way.
Lawrence O'Donnell at Greg Orman headquarters in Kansas, where Pat Roberts is projected to be the winner in that race. Thank you, Lawrence. I will say there's a lot of governor's races still outstanding at this point: Colorado, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Florida, Maine, Maryland, Kansas. One of those governor's races that has been called is for Wisconsin Governor Scott Walker. Do we have a little bit of Scott Walker's victory speech tonight? No, we don't. That's what you win. When Scott Walker wins, you win absolutely nothing.
I think Ed Schultz got rid of it, don't you?
You think so?
They killed the tape. Maybe.
Ed was like, I've got the audio block button on this one. Chuck Todd, while you're here, this race in Iowa, obviously, it's big news for Joni Ernst and for Iowa, but it's bigger news for the country in terms of Senate control for the Republicans.
It is, and I heard Chris right before I joined your table over here. This is a wave tonight. Let's not beat around the bush. This is a wave. This is a big win. They could get up to 9 seats. I think when you look at it, that's big. You look at brought up Scott Walker, we got Rick Scott, Maryland governor's not called yet. That says something. This was clearly Republican momentum at the end. They're going to have the largest House majority since World War II. Maybe they find another seat, and it's the largest number of Republicans in the House of Representatives since 1928. I don't know what else you want to come up to with the definition of wave. And listen to this stat. So Bruce Rauner, the new Republican governor-elect in Illinois, first time the president's home state governor lost re-election since 1892.